Chances are, if you're interested in space or the universe, you might have probably heard of black holes at one point or the other. And even if you aren't interested in space, you might have seen this very first photo of a black hole that went insanely viral last year around. So in order to clear up some of the mystery that surrounds these mind-defying stellar phenomena, let's have a look at how exactly black holes are formed. First, let's talk about how stars work. Initially, just after their formation, the core of most stars consists of an immensely large number of hydrogen atoms just whizzing around at an exceedingly high speed and at a very high temperature. Occasionally, these hydrogen atoms bump into each other to form heavy elements like helium, and then helium bumps into each other to form heavy elements like carbon and so on and so forth, making the core of the star very dense, while also releasing a tremendous amount of energy in the form of electromagnetic radiation, one form of which is the light that you see all around you. However, at the same time, there is the force of gravitation trying to bring all the mass of the star towards its center, trying to get it to collapse on itself. So what exactly prevents a star from gravitationally collapsing on itself instantaneously? To understand that, let's look at this pump right here. As I pump air into the ball, I'm being warm on the pump, which causes the temperature of the pump to increase. However, at the same time, you can see that it becomes harder for me to pump because the air molecules are pushing back with greater thermal pressure because the temperature of the pump has increased. So you can imagine that there is a tug of war occurring between me and the pump pushing back over here.
This is completely identical to what occurs within stars, except instead of me, it's the force of gravitation pushing into the core of the star, and instead of the pump, it is the thermal pressure due to the atoms pushing out. And it turns out that as the star keeps getting denser, the force of gravitation keeps getting stronger, so in most cases, there's only one winner in this tug of war, and it is gravitation.
From here on, it depends on the mass of the star. If the mass is comparable to that of our sun, the collapse is now halted by pressure exerted by electrons instead of atoms being packed into an incredibly small volume. Such a star is called a white dwarf, and our own sun is most likely going to end up this way. However, if the mass is greater, the electrons and protons within the star's core fuse to form neutrons due to the immense gravitational force. These stars are now supported by pressure exerted by these neutrons. These are called neutron stars and are some of the densest objects known to man. Lastly, if the mass is very large, there is absolutely nothing that can stop the star from gravitational collapse, and the entire mass contained within the star collapses to a single point of supposedly infinite density and no dimension. This is called a singularity, or what you more commonly know as the black hole. Understanding how black holes form is key to unraveling the mystery that surrounds these beautiful and at the same time terrifying objects. You see what I mean? Have a look and thank you.